There are countless experiments going on at any given time all around the planet, and many of them are on the stranger side. We decided to dig into the past and find some of the weirdest, most daring, and downright dangerous experiments that have taken place, and we've compiled the best ones right here for you. Prepare not only to be entertained, but disturbed as well. This is Extremely Strange Science Experiments. 11. Orgonomy. An Austrian psychoanalyst, doctor, and follower of Sigmund Freud named Wilhelm Reich claimed to have discovered what he called orgone energy in 1939. He stated that he had seen it in a few places, including inside mice after he injected them with bions, and in the sky using a special telescope that he called an organoscope. He started out by building small Faraday cages, which he insulated on his own and used to test his orgone theory on small animals, as he said they were orgone accumulators. He then graduated to building cages large enough for humans to fit inside, and without a medical license in America, began trying to treat cancer patients who were put inside of his strange boxes naked. He even wrote to Einstein about his contraption, and after extensive testing, Einstein concluded that they were nothing special. Reich was unhappy and published their correspondence years later out of spite. Eventually, Reich was cast out as crazy. 10. Project Cyborg. A British engineer and scientist, Kevin Warwick, has looked extensively into robotics, and he's really committed himself to his studies. Warwick has been given the nickname Captain Cyborg, as he's got a goal to become a cyborg and has had several chips and electrodes implanted into various parts of his body to do so. In August of 1998, he had an RFID transmitter embedded in his skin to control computer-controlled systems around him. In March of 2002, he had a neural interface implanted and linked his nervous system, and with it, he could control a robotic arm and was connected to the internet at Columbia University. His wife also had a simpler array implanted into her arm, and through the internet, their nervous systems could communicate, and he hopes to one day create a sort of telepathy via implantations. Can you imagine a world where telepathy and full control of robotic systems using electrodes and chips is possible? Sounds like one step closer to doomsday to us. 9. Homunculus. A homunculus is a fully formed miniature human, and the first mention of it comes from a Swiss alchemist, astrologer, and physician known as Paracelsus. Now, Paracelsus was no kook. In fact, he's called the father of toxicology and was a pioneer in the medical revolution. Way back in 1537, in De Natura Rerum, he outlines what his method would be to create a homunculus. His idea involved implanting human sperm into the womb of a horse, feeding the resulting being human blood, and allowing it to grow for 40 weeks. There are no records that show that any possible experimentation by Paracelsus, nor any other who may have tried to develop one, was successful. 8. Cardiac catheter. There was once a young German surgical trainee named Werner Forsman, who, against the advice of others, including his own department chief, found a way to catheterize the heart. The thing is, the first time he did it on himself. He was working at a hospital in Eberswalde, Germany, when he decided to perform his stunt, and he did it to show that it could be done, as many believed that any intrusion into the heart could prove fatal. Forsman managed to anesthetize his arm, incise a hole into his vein, and thread a catheter through it all the way to his heart. He walked to the X-ray department where technicians who had just been informed of what he was up to were waiting. When there, he used a fluoroscope to see what he was doing and then pushed the catheter into his ventricular cavity. X-rays were then taken and showed that the catheter had successfully been inserted into his right atrium. He was eventually awarded the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine for his feat, winning in 1956 alongside two others. 7. Frankenstein. Johann Conrad Dippel was a German physician, alchemist, and pietist theologian who was born in 1673 in Castle Frankenstein. He was known for doing some crazy things in the name of his science, and Emanuel Swedenborg, a man who was once Dippel's supporter and disciple, ended up describing Dippel as a most vile devil who attempted wicked things. There are rumors that Dippel experimented with soul transference with cadavers and even destroyed a tower at Castle Frankenstein. However, no real evidence of these things exist. He did experiment with animals who had recently passed away and concocted potions from boiling their flesh and bones that he said could exorcise demons. It's believed that the rumors of his experimentation with human cadavers and grave robbing inspired Mary Shelley's Frankenstein, although the claim is widely debated. 6. LSD. A long time ago, back on November 16, 1938, Dr. Albert Hofmann, a Swiss scientist, successfully synthesized LSD. He was researching derivatives of lysergic acids and was trying to obtain a circulatory and respiratory stimulant that had no effects on the uterus. He then put the LSD, or lysergic acid diethylamide 25, aside for years, until he decided to take a closer look at it in 1943. While he was resynthesizing it, he unknowingly touched some part of his face through which it was ingested, and he quickly became aware of its powerful effects. 3 days after his first accidental experience, he intentionally ingested 250 micrograms of the substance, and that day became known as Bicycle Day, as he first noted the effects taking hold while riding his bicycle home. For reference, 250 micrograms is 10 times the human threshold dose for LSD, so he undoubtedly had a good time during what was the first ever intentional LSD trip. Hofmann was also the first to synthesize psilocin and psilocybin, the principal compounds in psychedelic mushrooms. 5. Helicobacter pylori. Two doctors, Barry Marshall and Robin Warren, joined forces in 1981 and began studying the causes of gastritis. They found the bacteria H. pylori and came up with a hypothesis stating that it was the bacterial cause of gastric cancer and peptic ulcer. It's been said that many doctors and scientists ridiculed the ideas of Marshall and Warren, saying that there was no way bacteria could live in such acidic conditions. But boy, were they wrong. In the end, when their findings on a throat swab which grew H. pylori were ignored, Barry Marshall took a giant leap and ingested some himself to prove a point. He had a baseline endoscopy done, gulped down broth that contained cultures of the bacteria, and waited. Within 3 days, he developed halitosis and nausea. Within 5, he was vomiting. Within 8, he had gastritis, and a biopsy showed the bacteria had colonized his stomach. His extreme step to prove the hypothesis was published, and those naysayers shut their mouths. Marshall and Warren won the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine for their work in 2005. 4. Strange safety demonstration. A chemical and mechanical engineer named Thomas Midgley Jr. played a significant part in the development of leaded gasoline, as well as some of the initial chlorofluorocarbons, also known as Freon. He figured out that adding tetraethyl lead to regular old gasoline stopped the knocking in internal combustion engines while working at General Motors. Manufacturers developed a product from this, and it was advertised as anti-knock compound. The substance was called ethyl by the gasoline companies because they were wary of mentioning the lead it contained. The strangeness came in when, while attempting to demonstrate the safety of tetraethyl lead, he poured it all over his hands, put a bottle of it under his nose, and inhaled its vapors for 60 seconds straight. Days later, the product was banned from being made in New Jersey without state permission, and not too long after, Midgley was diagnosed with lead poisoning and had to take a leave of absence. 3. MKUltra. This is a pretty famous experiment, and it involved the CIA playing around with the possibility of mind control. There are a number of reasons the program was so controversial and why it became so famous. It began on April 13, 1953, and continued all the way through 1973. Although many question whether it really ended when it was reported to, and some wonder if it may still be a secret program today. The research took place in more than 80 different institutions and was even undertaken in Canada by a Scottish-born psychiatrist, Donald Ewan Cameron. The main focus? How certain drugs affected human beings and how those drugs could be used in interrogations. But they were also used to try to form ways to discredit, disable, and harass. 2. Acceleration and deceleration. A United States Air Force officer, physician, biophysicist, and flight surgeon named Colonel John Paul Stapp was widely known for his work during the Second World War as a flight surgeon. But that's not the only reason he became pretty famous. He also studied the effects of rapid acceleration and deceleration on the bodies of human beings, and he did so quite often by becoming the test dummy for his experiments. A rocket sled was built to determine these effects, and while some others also went for some of the wild rides on it, Stapp volunteered to board the sketchy machine more than almost anyone else. He was even injured more than once during the death-defying test, fracturing his wrist twice, losing the fillings in his teeth, breaking ribs, and experiencing bleeding into his retinas. He even far surpassed what was thought at the time as the most G-forces the human body could stand, 18 Gs, by putting his body through 38 Gs of force. He hit 632 miles per hour, and that earned him the nickname the fastest man on Earth. We've peered into the past and seen some truly strange science experiments so far, and we still have one more odd one to go. But first, we'd like to ask, what's the weirdest thing you've ever heard of done in the name of science? We'd love to read your answer down in the comments below. 1. Biosphere 2. An extraordinary science experiment began in Oracle, Arizona back in 1991, when 8 researchers entered what's known as Biosphere 2. They spent exactly 2 years inside trying to sustain themselves on what they could produce in the complex, all while conducting their research. It was supposed to be a self-sufficient system wholly closed off from the world and was named Biosphere 2, as Earth itself is the first entirely self-sufficient biosphere. Within the first year, the researchers experienced constant, continual hunger, and were actually fairly unhealthy. By midway through the first mission, they had even split up into 2 different factions, and people who had once been close friends became enemies of one another. At one point, someone was injured and treated away from Biosphere 2. And when that person returned, they were given additional supplies to take inside. But they made it through, and in 1994, a second mission began. In April of the same year, 2 of the first mission's researchers busted the place up from the outside, claiming they were concerned for the safety of the new team. The second mission ended early on September 6, 1994, and due to controversy, no other missions took place after that. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to do us a favor and give it a like. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel below or by clicking on our logo right here on this screen so you can stay up to date with all of our amazing content. Also, check out this next excellent video that we picked out just for you.